Hi everybody. Since I'm not doing any firewood processing today, I'm going to pull off the saw chain and put it on the chain grinder, do a quick touch up. Did probably 8 cords of firewood the other day, so it needs a quick touch up. So let's see if we can pull this off of here and have a look at it. Hey, leave it. No. No. Mauser, no. 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 The turkey is right at my feet, and the dog decides to come over and start barking at it. Turkey's still there, dog is gone, as I yell at him. So we'll just pop this loose here. Not too hard. Take the whole thing with me. Go get the chain off the sprocket. Hey, no. I'll just lay that down in there. I'll probably flip the bar over too, so I'm going to take the whole thing with me. Oh, geez, turkey. Turkey is literally standing right up against me when I do that. I think he's lonely. That can all stay right there. Okay, come on. Come on, you too. Let's go. Come on, turkey. We're going down to the shop. Before I do any grinding on or inspecting or anything on this chain, I'm going to clean it. So, just get the parts washer going here. Just let that drip dry for a minute. Wipe my hands off. The parts washer does a great job of cleaning the chain. And now I'm just going to use compressed air to blow all the remaining solvent off. And now the chain is clean and dry. The solvent dries pretty fast. Yep, that's fine. That looks good. What I've done is I've set up my little microscope. This is the microscope that I use for doing electronics work. So what I want to do here is I want to inspect the chain a little bit. And I'm just going to go through with the microscope and look at some of these teeth. And I'll take a few pictures. And really, they look pretty good, considering how much wood we did. But they definitely need a touch-up as well. I do not normally do this. I do not normally inspect every tooth. Just kind of doing this for the video. And there's a good example of a tooth that has some rough spots on it. So the turkey is outside crying and carrying on because he doesn't know where I'm at. So here he is. Yes, I know I'm going to have to wipe up big blobs of poop. But he wants to be here, so let him sit here. Oops. All right, did I wake you up? Were you sleeping? You were sleeping? Okay. All right, I put the chain in the grinder, and I haven't done any settings yet. The first thing I want to do is I want to dress this wheel. The shape is fine, but it's got a little bit of crud in it from the last chains that I did. So I want to turn this on and I want to dress it up a little bit. And all I'm going to do is just gently touch my dressing stone to the wheel. Now, if the wheel was out of shape, I would use a different tool. Okay, I'm already set on the grinder. My chain, the grinding angle is 60 degrees. The top plate angle is 35 degrees. And the down angle is set to 10 degrees. So we're all set to start grinding. All I need to do now is adjust my chain stop. Now what I've done is I've adjusted the chain stop so that I can just barely skim the tooth. So I'll show you what that looks like. And that just barely touched it. I need to take a little more off than that, so I'm just gonna kick this up a little bit. And now what I'm doing is I'm moving the chain in that direction. Just ever so slightly. And now I'll try it again. And we're just taking a little tiny bit off, not much. Now I'm going to take this tooth and I'm going to look at it under the microscope. What I'm going to do is I'm going to color this tooth with some Dykem. That way I know that's the tooth I started with. So based on the picture that I took, I need to take just a little bit more off. Not much. So we're going to turn the adjuster in a little bit more. Again, I'm moving the chain in that direction. Just the tiniest little bit. I'm trying to do this working around the camera. Okay, let's see if I can see that. Yep. Okay. Okay, so now we're just going to take a little bit more off, and then we'll look at it under the microscope again. Because there were a few teeth that were actually, they had some dings on them. We'll put this back under the microscope and look at it again. So as you can see from the close-up picture, you want to be very careful about taking too much material off too quickly. So as you can see, the tip of the tooth just slightly started turning blue. So I have to be careful with that and not be too aggressive. Okay, on to the next tooth. And now I'm just going to keep on going. One tooth at a time. I'm not going to put each tooth under the microscope, but I am going to look at them. I'm going to spot check them once in a while. So, very gently. That's it. I'm going to do the rest of the teeth, and I'll come back at the end. The last thing I'm doing here is I'm spot checking my rakers. And I'm also trying not to step on the turkey, who is exactly underneath my feet. And I know there's some parallax here. It's kind of hard for you to see it. 48 thousandths on that raker. I think I'm going to leave these alone until the next sharpening. That one's at 49, so they're pretty darn close. That one's 49. I only took a very minimal amount of material off these teeth. And the trick is you have to get it centered, and the gauge has to be perched exactly on the tip of the teeth. So there's 46. That one's a little bit high. Ooh, hey, what are you doing? Don't peck me. Don't peck me. Lay down. Go sit down. 47. So that one's a little bit on the high side. I'm not going to worry about these this time. I'm going to wait till the next sharpening. So I'm going to look at a couple teeth under the microscope, and then we're going to call it good. All right, so thank you for watching the quick chainsaw sharpening video, and we'll see you later.